In complex analysis, we will rely later on heavily on several notions of topology, like interior points, open set, and connected sets. It may be intuitively clear to you what these notions mean, but let's take a look at the precise definitions, because we will need those later. In this video, we will take a look at the concepts of interior, exterior, and boundary points. So first we need the notion of a neighborhood, the neighborhood of Z0, B epsilon of Z0. That's a set of points, Z, in the complex plane, which are at most at a distance epsilon of Z0. So a small disk centered at Z0 and then the ones closer than epsilon to Z0. Then we have the something almost the same, the deleted neighborhood of Z0. It's the same except for the fact that Z0 is not part of its set. So you can write it as this is Z0 smaller than norm of Z minus Z0 smaller than epsilon. So how does that look in the figure? So a neighborhood of Z0 first. Here we have our Z0 and I made a full dot to show that the Z0 is part of the set. Then we have a disk around it, is radius epsilon, and a neighborhood of Z0 is a set of all points inside here, but not with the points at distance exactly epsilon. So the deleted neighborhood of Z0 is exactly the same, except for the set that Z0 is not part of the set. So I made a dotted circle around Z0 to indicate that Z0 is not part of the deleted neighborhood of Z0, but further it's completely the same. Now, what's the interior point of a set? Well, a point Z0 is an interior point of a set S. If you can find a neighborhood around the Z0, which is entirely in S. So here we have our Z0, which is, well, intuitively it's clear that Z0 is in S. And why is that? You can make a small disk around it, which is entirely contained in S, as you see over here. Z0 is an exterior point of S. Well, if it's outside of S, and that's how it is defined, here we have a Z1. Next point is clearly outside of S. Why is it an exterior point? Well, if you can find a neighborhood which is entirely outside of S. Well, in this case, you see you can find such a neighborhood over here. You can make a small disk around our Z1, which is entirely outside of S. And that means that Z1 is an exterior point of S. So we have interior points of S, we have exterior points of S, and, well, some points are neither, and those points are called boundary points of S. So they are neither, if a point is neither interior nor exterior, then it's called a boundary point of S. And what does that mean? Well, you cannot make a neighborhood which is entirely inside S or outside S, so it means any neighborhood you make around it will have points both of S and of the complement of S. And that's what you see for our Z2, which is, well, intuitively it's clear that it's on the boundary. And you see what happens if you make a neighborhood around it. Any neighborhoods will contain both points of S and of the complement of S. So intuitive notions of interior, exterior, and boundary points coincide with the mathematical notions, but the mathematics, we make it a bit more precise using the notion of the concept of a neighborhood.